In this episode, we'll be looking at why you used to watch the telly with a remote in your hand. What is loudness? Well, a few years ago, everyone was of the mind that they wanted their audio to be the loudest, so it'd stand out from the crowd. In music, you end up with hugely compressed and highly maximized, but ear-bleeding walls and noise that leave you reeling. In broadcast, every advertising exec wanted their advert to be the loudest in the break. Ultimately, the ads were much louder than the program content that it surrounded. Something had to be done. Thankfully, legislation stepped in to say this had to stop. Now, because of the resulting loudness standards, our world is a much nicer place to be when listening to broadcast. What are the loudness standards? Well, depending on where you live, you'll fall under a different, though not too different, standard. In Europe, it's R128. The States, it's ATSC A85, and a few others around the world. The standards are there to ensure that the perceived loudness of the show is the same as the ads and the show before and after, leaving the listener in a far more comfortable position without repetitive strain of the thumb that's working the volume control. How do we get to comply to these standards? Well, broadcast needs to be mixed to the appropriate standard using various meters to make sure that your mix is compliant from the get-go. There are various versions out there, such as LMN from TC Electronics, Insight by Isotope, or WLM from Waves, but the outright leader, in my opinion, is the Loudness Suite from New Gen Audio. I've been mixing with these plugins at the end of my mix for years now, and I've nothing but respect for these products. I use a plugin called ISL, which is a true peak limiter, and VizLM, which tells me everything about my compliance. Simple to use, and metering that delivers you compliance without thinking. It reflects what I'm hearing exactly, without any influence. After you've printed your loudness compliant master, you need to be absolutely sure of your deliverables. You can check your master file with LM Correct. Again, simple to use, it ensures that your master is totally compliant anywhere on the planet. There are other plugins that do the same thing, but they're either not easy to use or they influence the mix. I'll touch on LM Correct in another episode relating to deliverables, but I want to mention an extension that they have called DynAPT. It controls the LRA, the loudness range, which is the dynamic of the show. Consider a movie with loud action sequences to the other quiet parts. The dynamic range is too much for a broadcast playout, so you have to reduce the LRA or the loudness range. Now, you can do this by remixing your film mix to suit TV, but you mightn't have the budget. So this is where the DynAPT extension comes in. You can reduce the loudness range without affecting your mix. Again, as with all plugins, be careful adjusting the parameters. Don't destroy your mix. Listen carefully to your results. The NewGen Loudness Suite is my desert island suite of plugins for any work, either in stereo or surround, film or broadcast. They've served me well for years in everything I do. I love the technology and the simplicity, without them influencing my mix adversely. Nice one, NewGen. I'm Keith Alexander and you've been watching Adorama TV. Don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV for more great videos. And tell us what you think. You can like, comment, or share this video. And please come by the Adorama Learning Center for more information and advice.